In today's episode, Caroline asks, what's better than Google Analytics to measure what your visitors are actually doing when on your website? So there's a ton of really good software packages out there that do stuff like this. There's Clicktail, there's Crazy Egg, Lucky Orange. But the one that I've been playing with most recently that does a really good job, keeps it simple, and is also free, is from this little company you might have heard of called Microsoft. They released this package called Microsoft Clarity that a lot of people, when it first was announced, were incorrectly comparing it to Google Analytics, calling it a Google Analytics killer. It's not. It is a very different application than Google Analytics. What it is a Hotjar killer, or at the very least, a worthy competitor to all those different companies I just mentioned. Because it's Microsoft, so you know that while the product itself could be discontinued, the company's probably not going anywhere. And B, it's free. Can't really complain about that. So what is this thing, and how do we use it with our website? Let's go ahead and move things around here. Okay, so what you've probably noticed in Google Analytics is that there's actually not a whole lot of useful stuff in Google Analytics for looking at your site. What you need is something that can track the interactions that users are having on your site. So that's where Clarity comes in. Setting it up, very straightforward. It is like every single other tracking program. You just put your tracking pixel on your site. I used Google Tag Manager to do it, and it was pretty straightforward. Let's go ahead and connect my site here. And now I've got my Google Analytics integration there. Now, let's go to the dashboard and see what this does. You do get some basic analytics, and that's nice. You can see sessions and things like that. But again, there's no things in here that are specified like goals and goal completions and all that stuff. You're not going to get that level of detail. What you do get, though, is a lot of UI stuff, user interface stuff, dead clicks where people are clicking on parts of the page that they think should do something and don't. You get rage clicks, which I appreciate. People just rapidly clicking on the same space, excessive scrolling. These are good indicators that people are lost, right? There's something wrong with your site. And then you get to scroll down and see pages that people have gone back on, pages with JavaScript errors that you might want to fix up. Like all of the other user experience tools, you get recordings and heat maps. So recordings are pretty straightforward. You go in, you tap on the recording, and then you get to watch somebody navigating your website and see what it is that they do. And this will give you hints, for example, like, oh, this person maybe isn't reading the fullest part of the article, things like that. If I skip forward here, what are they doing? Oh, they're trying to copy and paste, it looks like. Yep, they're trying to copy and paste text from my site. That's interesting. And then in addition to recordings, you, of course, get the heat maps, right? Where are people clicking on your page? And you get the chance to see those clicks, what people are doing on your site. Let's go back to our dashboard here. As far as I can tell, there aren't any significant limits or restrictions yet. But even if there were, just out of the box, this isn't bad, right? It's simple. It's straightforward. It tells you very quickly, hey, there's either things wrong with your website or there's not. I'm not terribly concerned about the dead click stuff. As we were seeing just now, people were actually trying to copy and paste text, which is interesting. I think I'll just give some thought about that. And then things like JavaScript errors. Okay, that's something I need to fix, right? If people are running into issues on my site where JavaScript is spitting up on them, I probably need to go ahead and do some investigation and tune that up. Again, with any of these diagnostics, you can either click in on just that part of the audience, right? You can see 15% of those people who had JavaScript errors had Chrome issues or were on Chrome. Let's go ahead and look at Safari, Apple users. It only had 8% of that, so Safari fares a little bit better. But this is a really handy tool. Now, here's the catch with a tool like this. It could, as with everything, is spitting up a lot of information. So the number one thing we have to do is be very clear, what is it that we're trying to find out? Are we trying to find out that conversions are down on a specific page? If so, find that page in our list of pages just use the filters to identify which particular pages you might want. And you can see there's tons and tons of different filters you can use. Are we looking for user experience problems? Are we dealing with a retention problem where people are leaving quickly? For example, we have this quick packs here where it is people who navigate to a page and then and left quickly. Okay, let's take a look at that. What pages are they to start with? And then you can watch the recordings and say, they either, based on what they're doing on screen, they either did or they didn't find what they were looking for. So with a tool like this, we've got to be clear about what it is that we want to know and what it is that what our goal is, what decisions we're going to make, because it's a fun tool, right? You can spend a lot of time in here, but you can also waste a lot of time, right? And if you don't have time to waste, you have to be very clear about what decision you want to make. When you look at each of these things, what is the decision that is in here? Dead clicks, right? Your decision you're trying to make is, do I need to add navigation to my site because something is unclear, right? Do I need to change the formatting to make it clear what the clickable objects are and what are not? A lot of sites tend to like to, you know, change the color or mask the color of hyperlinks. Okay, maybe that's not the best idea if you're getting a lot of dead clicks. And in order to understand that, and this is where this product can run into trouble, we need to understand the priority of the pages we should be looking at and what issues those pages have. So let me give you an example. Let's put in our URL newsletter. Okay, we're going to apply that. And this is my newsletter page, right? Six of these visits. Let's click on that. Now, this is a landing page. Right. This is, therefore, a very important page to my site. I want to very specifically look at this page and go, huh, are there things here that I should be worried about that are blocking conversion? But if I didn't know that, this tool would not tell me that I needed to be looking at this particular landing page. So you'd want to know that going into this. Hey, we've got a landing page conversion problem. Maybe there's something that we can take a look at in here that tells us our landing pages are running into trouble. To get to that conclusion, you need to work in Google Analytics data. That will help you understand, okay, these are the priority pages to investigate, then come into clarity and say, now let's investigate those pages to understand why things are happening. It's sort of like essentially watching a focus group, right? Or a one-on-one user interview. You can see why they're doing the things that they're doing on that page. But analytics will tell you what pages to look at, because otherwise you'll waste hours in here just clicking around with no clear conclusions. So to answer Caroline's question, what's better than Google Analytics for actually on your website? Microsoft Clarity. As long as you don't have any administrative or legal or regulatory restrictions on installing it, I would go ahead and install it. Give it a spin. It doesn't cost you anything. Setting it up is as simple as setting up any other tool. And I think it's a nice complement to Google Analytics. I think, especially since Google took away, you know, what little click tracking they had, I think this is a great companion to Google Analytics, and use both of them. If you got follow-up questions, leave them in the comments box below. Subscribe to the YouTube channel and the newsletter. I'll talk to you soon. Take care. Want help solving your company's data analytics and digital marketing problems? Visit trustinsights.ai today and let us know how we can help you.